No, that's not the case, because you have a face and a daughter has a face. What they're doing, just clarifying, same ism doesn't not necessitate same form or same way, the same reality, you understand? Yeah, negated all of that. The point here is we have to seek the Quran and the Sunnah and read the book of the Salaf. Philosophy is a disaster. Ibn Taymiyyah, may Allah have mercy upon him, said, "Ma fi falasifa fil Islam." There is no philosophers in Islam. Islam, there are scholars. So how can you lie and say Ibn Taymiyyah is a philosopher? If Ibn Taymiyyah said, there is no philosophers in Islam. You know, and they say Al-Ghazali, he read Shifa, he became sick. You know Shifa, Kitab al-Qadi. Yeah, Ibn Sina, Afwan, Ibn Sina. And the Shifa, what he means? Shifa means cured.
To be cured.
To be cured. But he read, he became sick. Why? Because he's not Shifa. He's a marad. Why? He's full of philosophy. And the full of philosophy, and let me expose the lies. Philosophy does not mean utilizing sound reasoning. That got angers the Quran. The proof of that, Allah said in the Quran, Surah Al-Mulk, وَقَالُوا لَوْ كُنَّا نَسْمَعُ أَوْ نَعْقِلُ مَا كُنَّا فِي أَصْحَابِ السَّعِيرِ. The kuffar in Jahannam, they will say, if we did utilize our hearings correctly and our sound reasoning correctly, we will never be in the hellfire. Because if they utilize their sound reasoning correctly and hear it correctly, they'll accept the truth. But because they utilize it in a poison way, like philosophy, they reject the truth. So philosophy does not mean utilizing sound reasoning. If this is the case, majority of philosophers would be Muslims. But the fact is, majority are kuffar and enemies of the prophets and messengers. Alhamdulillah.
Another clarification
to the nation about the situation.
Another clarification is when people say that Allah has two right hands, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I know this is a big topic. And
yeah, yeah.
This just really give a lesson in itself.
Yeah.
What are those people who say that having Allah has two right hands? And they contradict another hadith in Sayyid Bukhari where it says that Allah has a left hand.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, okay, I understand. So the two right hands here, firstly, when you say how, you try to limit Allah to His creation. Allah, let's say, like cliche. We're not like the Christians. The Christians stop trying to utilize Allah's mental attributes to justify your disbelief. Because we know what is a baby. By definition, if you tell me God become a baby, you know you're chatting nonsense. That's why there is why we say to you, this is called rubbishism. You know, rubbish. Rubbishism. This is my new word. I'm going to utilize Angus Majanin. This is called rubbishism, philosophy. It is rubbish. How you tell me God become a baby? By definition, baby is created. By definition, babies need the milk. By definition, baby has to go to a toilet. By definition, baby needs the food. By definition, a baby is weak. By definition, Allah is uncreated. By definition, Allah is the most powerful. Try to explain that. There's no way you can explain it except by follow rubbishism. The point here, I follow the explanation of Sheikh Saleh al-Sheikh and other scholars. The meaning of Allah's two right hands means both Allah's hand is blessed. Because al-yameen comes from the word tayammun. Do you understand?
So,
meaning Allah's two right hands mean both of Allah's hand are blessed. Not mean both of them in the right side or something like that. Both of them are blessed. Do you understand? Because yameen also comes from tayammun. Tayammun means blessed. So ask for that explanation. But even logically, how does Prophet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You know, I mean, I can have two right hands here. I can have two right hands. I can have one hand here and one hand here. So anyway, the point here is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the web of His majesty. Understand? So the meaning of the hadith means both Allah's hands are blessed. That's what it means. So it means, doesn't mean the actual right, like, because yameen has many meanings. And here, ta'wil according to the Arabic language. Not like the ta'wil of Ash'ariyya, which is batil. Like some Ash'aris these days, they've been after us. They say, Imam Bukhari said, كل شيء هالك إلا وجهه. They say, and Bukhari says, mean the mulk. That's one of the manuscripts. Some scholar doesn't really follow the manuscript. But in the same one, he said, also mean Allah's face. But sometimes the scholars of the Salaf, they explain the ayat according to the topic of the verses. Because this verse, I believe in Surah Al-Qasas, if I don't remember exactly, is speaking about the mulk of Qarun and Haman and Fir'aun. So Allah mentioned, nothing will remain except Allah, what belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. that doesn't go and guess proving Allah has a face the way it's been for His Majesty. That's why when Allah said in the Quran, يَوْمَ يُكْشَفُ عَنْ سَاقٍ. Na'am? Some scholars in the past, meaning said here, on that day will be severe. Why? Because the ayah has both meaning. But those who explain it this way, doesn't only negate Allah has a shin the way with His Majesty. Do you understand that? And now if I say I have a clock, has a hand, has a face, has a legs, you're not going to figure it's a human being. Do you understand? وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى. Nothing belongs to nothing like unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You understand? So the yameen, this yameen means to go in line with the other narration, mean tayammun, mean both Allah's hands are blessed. Yeah, both.
Really nice explanation. What books would you recommend the brothers and sisters to learn from when it comes to that aspect?
I mean, look, not because he's my teacher, I have to say that, but I haven't come across no one speaks about this issue in the English world in details like Sheikh Abu Iyad, Amjad Rafiq. He speaks in details about this issue. He has a website called ashari.com, abovethethrone.com, Ibn Taymiyyah, Abu Iyad, Amjad Rafiq. Aqidah.com. He explained all of that. And he exposed many Ash'aris and Dubendis who like against Ibn Taymiyyah, tried to misquote, and he gave a nice talk in Bradford, Majid Sunnah. I want to remember with me and Anwar and the brother Abdurrahman from Makkah Sunnah. It was a beautiful talk. He started from the beginning, from the philosophy, from the Yunan time, the Greeks and the Romans, how Judaism was affected by it, how Christianity, and how the Muslims. And there's two groups here, followers of the Rasul al-Anbiya and the followers of the philosophers. But to understand that the Ash'aris do follow philosophers, you have to study the tariq. Do you understand history? How they started? Why? Ash'a'ira are explaining Allah's name, some Allah's names, attribute away. Why? Or Allah's attribute, why? What is the reason? Because they say if you affirm that, you affirm Allah has a body. Who came with this term body? Jabir ibn Safwan. Why? Who said, even, look, that, what do you mean by body? That's why when you say, Afwan.
Jism means.
No, when you say, what do you mean by jism? Because this term, Salaf never used jism. Salaf used that. That, be that he. So when you say jism, what do you mean by jism? Because that's why when you negate, that's why when someone says something to you, don't if it's unclear, ask him, what do you mean by that? Why are you asking him? Why are you asking this question? Because you have the Quran, the Sunnah as a criteria. If the statement goes in line with the Quran and Sunnah, we say we accept it. However, we have a term in the Quran and the Sunnah. But maybe this person, that's how they speak. You understand? So for example, if someone tell me, Allah has a body, what do you mean by body? Like human beings or any creation? Or you mean Allah has an essence? Allah has a face, the way of His Majesty? Allah exists outside of the reality. You know, قَائِم بِدَاتِهِ. If you mean that, then we say don't use this term because you can confuse the people. We stick to the Quran and the Sunnah.
ليس كمثله شيء.
وهو السميع البصير. You see, even some people they play around. They say, okay, you say we know the meaning of the hand. What does it mean? He's playing around. Because if I said to you, look, my daughter, she hurt her hand. Are you going to think her eyes? Are you going to think her face? You're going to understand what is hand correctly. So the hand is understandable. But now what is? We leave it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I mean the kayfiyya. Yeah. Yeah. They're playing around.
Yes.
They say, what do you mean by hand? Okay, you understand what is hand. Stop playing around. But he wants to drag you into conversation to do what? To push you into kayfiyya. So be aware. You know, if I said to a brother, what they call it, one brother has something in his face, he will never understand he has something in his feet. So why are you playing around? Stick to the Quran and the Sunnah. Allah has a face. You are better than Allah. That's why, who are you better than the Sahaba? Sahaba, they ask about the Mahid. The woman menses. Which one is more important? The woman menses or Allah? Allah Jalla wa Ala. Allah has an attribute. How come they never said, Ya Rasulullah, what does it mean face? Ya Rasulullah, what does it mean hand? Yeah, that's what Sheikh Al-Uthaymeen said. There is ijma' that they understood according to the lugha. What is the ijma' he said here? He said the ijma' they never asked Prophet ﷺ, what is the meaning of that? And they were the most eager to understand the book of Allah. Especially when Allah said, وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى فَادْعُوهُ بِهَا.
Even
anything, we don't even have a mawdu' hadith on that.
Huh?
We don't even have a mawdu' hadith.
It's Allahu Akbar. This is fa'id. I didn't know that. There's no. No, no, no. Given that's true.
No, I mean,
but you give analogy. Analogy to make sense. But that's true. Wala wala tadribu lillahi amthal. They don't give examples to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yeah. They look like this. Na'am. But here the Salaf used it to understand. Because why? You know, Ali ibn Abi Talib said, كان العلم نقطة واحدة. Knowledge was a dot. Little dot. كثره الجهال. Who made it bigger? The ignorant ones. What does it mean? Sheikh Saleh al-Sheikh said, means when the people of ignorance are speaking, the ulama had to clarify.
Yeah.
If the jahal kept silent, the ulama, they will keep it normal. But they had to write a book clarifying. Do you understand? Rahimahumullah. May Allah have mercy upon them and forgive them. Barakallahu fiik. Lakum Allah khair.